And then the fans and all that, in a way, makes it easier for you because you know you're making a movie for people that cares about it, right? There's people, for good and for bad, people are waiting. Like, they want to see it. They care about what you're doing. Usually when you make a new thing that nobody knows about it, you know, you have to struggle to get people to care about your film. So, so I always saw the bright side of, you know, being, you know, making it, of making an Evil Dead film.
What scene was hardest for you to shoot, most challenging, or what part of this experience?
Man, the whole thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Any one thing that...
No, it was like every day was like an impossible feat. But I got an ear infection from all that paint stuck in my ear from the blood rain, and that was not fun.
No, really?
I got buried alive.
You could see on the extras, on the Blu-ray, you can see Jane go like, there's something in my ear, can I, you know, I leave now?
Yeah, oh,
are we
gosh.
Done? And no, it's, no, just do another shot. And we know that, now I know that she was getting all this blood
the
in her ear.
Infection.
Actually, like a true side. Story.
Yeah.
Blood was coming out of my ear. Like, it took
really?
A long time for my body to, no, it's this, it's tempera paint. It's,
okay.
It's paint and water mixture, but like, it got stuck in my ear and it like infected my ear canal and everything. And so, up to 3 months after we were shooting the movie, I would still, like, after the shower, I'd clean my ear with a Q-tip, and there would be red paint. Like, it took a really long time for my body to finally, like, get it all. It, like, went, maybe it's probably in my brain. It's probably going to be brain damage. I don't know. Does your ear connect to your brain, even, or is that, like,
it
total?
Was it challenging for you to push your actors, or you were, like, you went into it with that mindset?
It was fun. I mean, sometimes you feel bad, and because you know it's gonna be a hard day, or you come up with an idea like that is a little bit perverse, and you want to pull it off. So you approach Jane, and she's already miserable, and it's only 8 a.m. and you go like, well, anyways. But you know, like, pain is temporary, movies are forever, and whatever is happening in the moment.
That's the
like,
line.
Brutal.
It's true. Like,
no, it is true.
Right there.
Nobody cares. When you watch the movie, there's no excuses. There's no like, oh, this scene didn't turn out well because blah, blah, blah. Nobody cares about that. You want to see a good scene.
Of course.
And the audience, you know, there's no, doesn't come with a manual, the movie. I was like, oh, that scene didn't turn out good because of this. That was hard to make. Like, they don't care. They want to see a great scene. So
yeah.
You have to do what you have to do. Then the pain is just a, you know, somatic.
Yeah, at this point in my life, I don't even remember really. But I had this one time I was driving home, and we had drivers because we were in New Zealand, and they didn't trust us to drive on the other side of the road. And I had this lovely man named Matt who I got to like talk to before and after work every day, and we were driving, and he was quiet, and he said like, Jane, have they like, is it part of your contract to have like a psychiatrist? And it was so sincere, and he was like so worried about me, and I thought it was so sweet, and it was so funny, and I was like, no, it wasn't. Should be.
The future of the film, the franchise, where do you see this going, obviously, and then, you know, the introduction back, Ash's character again, how do you see this evolving?
I hope that we can make a film where we combine the mythologies, you know, not mythologies, the stories, and particularly the characters, right, into the last film. So it's hard to do because you don't want to make a film that the audience that is not familiar to the original will feel that they're missing out on something.
Right.
So you have to do it in a way that it feels like a continuation of this film, and you bring the characters of the original in a way that even if you haven't seen them, you will understand what's going on. Right. Mm-hmm. So that's the trick right now, and that's the thing too. We're trying to figure it out.